Bill?
Yes.
Well, why don't you tell them
who
you are? What are they looking at when they see you?
You're looking at a middle-aged man who's slightly, I'm sorry.
And that's how this is going
this
to go.
Is how the, this is pretty much the whole thing. So my name is Bill Benham, and I'm a producer for the Dungeons & Dragons team. And today I'll be playing the part of Grimble Glottis. Grimble is a goblin who enjoys going to places that have not been visited by other people in a while, and then acquiring the things that may have been left there. He's a funny little fella. He likes to sing songs, and he's really partial to shadow magic. So I think that's gonna be fun later. But yeah, that's me. I'm Bill. I'm playing Grimble.
My name is Teos, Abadia, and I like to write a lot of RPG stuff whenever I can, when I'm not doing my day job. Today, I will play Grom Two Eyes, not at all like Grumsh. This very safe half-orc is a death cleric, and and I'm excited to command the two goblins we have at this table.
And I'm Jenny Loveday. I also, I guess, write D&D and a D&D stream and podcast, and all of the things that everyone does in the free time when I'm not doing my day job. And I am playing Greta Gooch. I am a interior goblin triplet. Of course, my siblings are inferior to me, and therefore they are not here today. I'm by far the best of the triplets. I am a sorcerer with a focus on blowing stuff up. And he will not be commanding me, despite what he believes.
Because you're good at most of
yes! Of course! Why would you ask that?
My name is Alan Patrick. I am a retired Adventurers League administrator. I am a freelance adventure designer now. Full-time I do nerdy IT things in a lot of different avenues. For today's character, I'm playing a half-orc by the name of Dirth. I believe that I am a druid, and that is simply because mechanically I am a warlock of the Archfey, and I refuse to believe that I am enthralled to someone else.
Is that a good call?
No.
You are.
Absolutely not.
Yes.
And I will eat dirt about it.
I'm Shawn Merwin. I'm the lead executive designer for Ghostfire Gaming. I have been an AL administrator in the past, as well as a freelance game designer. I'll be playing Strom Five Eyes, a war wizard who dropped out from a correspondence school in Waterdeep.
We've all been there.
The ITT tech.
And
I didn't want to name names.
Yes. You're out of business.
And somehow they managed to get hired by a priest of Osiris. They are in the country known as Mulhoran, which had a very bad time during that thing called the spell plague and the sundering. They're still rebuilding their country. And there's a lot of temples and places that they haven't visited in a long time. And they sent a group of about 20, half of which were like wet behind the ears acolytes, to go and spruce up this old temple that hadn't been used, called the Temple of Terraces of Plenty. And it's a temple to Osiris as aspect of the god of the harvest versus the god of the dead. And they got back a message that sort of said, monsters here, and possibly the word help. It was kind of garbled, and that's when the message ended. So they decided to hire a group that might be able to figure out what's going on at their temple. They would prefer the temple to still be standing when you're done. They're fairly certain that all of the party that they sent are now in the arms of Osiris. So there's no one left to rescue, sadly. So they sent you on a nice little ship up the river to the mountains at the edge of Mulhoran. And you arrive at this nice little floating dock. And there's a set of stairs going up to a place with a bunch of pillars, kind of very open. No roof, just a bunch of pillars, sort of like saying, here's the start of the path. I'm assuming you're going to go along with that.
Well, yeah.
That's what paths are for.
That's right.
That's what paths are for.
They get me from A to wherever I need to go.
Grum, look at Jean.
The obvious solution is simply the correct. And if not, we can just, wait, no, don't do it. Don't do it.
I'm goblin up there.
I, powerful, noble cleric. This time when Grandma say, one must carefully look at team and see which ones are likely to be cold.
Please do.
Right, what?
Two little ones.
Yeah.
No. Sorry, Grandma give vision. Grandma give vision. Also, too many eyes. I cast upon you Grandma's blessing. And I give you aid, so you guys have 15 extra hit points.
What?
That's
so helpful.
Otherwise, you not make it.
Oh, I see.
Oh, also, I have blessed necklace. Funny hat.
Ooh, shiny.
Mm.
What's that for?
Apparently not have it. Bad things.
Now, we came looking for hemp, right? The message said hemp.
Help.
Oh, never mind.
I'm still looking for hemp, like if that helps. That's fine. I like where you're going with this.
It's a subtle distinction.
Bye bye.
Common, not first language.
Steps, whether they're outside of being a little worn and a little old, still are fine. You go up them.
Mm-hmm.
And now you see why they call it the Terraces of Plenty. Because you have a long path in front of you, but cut into the side of the mountain are five terraces that seem like they should have stuff growing in it, but it's all brown and ugly and dried out. And then there's another terrace with lots of columns, and then there's another terrace past that. So apparently they are being fairly literal on the terraces. But the pathway that goes up to it, about halfway down, you see there are a number of sphinx on either side. Stone.
Okay. Oh,
stone.
Good.
Out of
stone.
That clear.
I hope everyone will stay stone.
And as you approach,
there's going to be lots of approaching.
The heads of the sphinxes turn toward you.
I thought they said stone.
I just thought they were going to stay.
No,
they are stone. They still seem to be stone, but the heads are.
Hello, little Grimble. Jews.
Trigger trap, Grimble, go.
What?
No, I'm going to talk to them.
Oh, please,
no.
Yes, after
you. He's talking to the moving statues. You talk.
You speak stone?
I'm dead trap.
Probably, but we speak to them. Hello, moving statues. Are you going to move any closer to us? Please do not.
They don't seem to be responding to you at all.
No. I'm going to move closer to one of them and just like jab that a little bit.
It does seem to be stone.
Excellent. Still stone.
Are you jabbing it to the side or front?
No, I'm just going to go right into space in case it missed me somehow.
Okay.
Poor life choices. Yes, pretty much.
Poor life choices. Yeah. A shot of red fire comes out of its eyes.
Nope.
Those cross. Dexterity saving throw.
Nope.
I'm always right.
No. An eight.
Hold on. I may be able to help with this. Hold on. One moment, please.
He can make it worse.
Loading.
Well, I can always make it worse.
So
like that's the story.
Are you helping me or are you helping the statue?
No, I'm helping you, man.
Statue.
Why would I help a statue?
Fortunately, I do at least have a little bit of resistance to fire because I've gotten into a sticky situation once or twice or 12 times. Sometimes explosions are so controlled.
Okay, so Gribble's going to shout encouraging words at you. They have no actual effect other than making you feel slightly better about yourself.
You make me feel a little warm when you lost the fire.
But at the end of all it, you will have bardic inspiration after the fight. fire shoots out and scorches you. Yes. Yes, it is a die six. Sorry, I could not be of more assistance.
It's great.
Yeah, I mean, this is typical rebel.
And then I use jazz hands. It doesn't do anything.
It's just
makes me feel better about the situation.
Yeah. Probably should have brought my siblings. Okay,
yes.
That's useless.
Yeah, since it does like 6 points of fire damage to you as it scrapes your head.
Burns. I'll take 3.
Don't forget special grandma medicine.
Oh yes, I did that already.
It made us all smell like a vinegar fart.
It made of entrails.
I smell mouth.
Bad engine.
Does it come in ribbon candy?
No.
It came out of a tin. It came out of a tin cookies.
Close enough.
But now that you're so close and it attacked you, you realize that the appearance of it turning was actually an illusion.
It is still stone.
It is still stone. It is still straight. But so if you'd actually not gone in front of it, it might not have hit you.
Well,
not bad.
My luck. Everybody have an important announcement. It didn't actually move.
Mm-hmm.
It did actually burn, though.
Mm.
I don't recommend approaching. One star.
One star would not get burned by again. Grimble is going to take out a wand. He's going to futz with it for a second, and he is going to cast Detect Magic.
Mm.
And let's see. I guess I'll be within 30 feet of the statues. And what kind of aura do I see? What kind of school of magic? Is it just illusion magic, or is there anything else
just,
I have over there?
Just illusion and a little aberration.
Okay, great. And is there space that we could like walk around?
Oh, there's lots of space.
There's a whole terrace. We can keep walking up. I just
then
pick
that's
you up and
you pick
you're
up.
Basically on a path, and it's bare on either side. So they're lining the path. You can walk around. It's basically dirt. Sand.
Okay. So that was a self-inflicted wound.
Absolutely.
Okay, cool.
That's my specialty.
But what if cunning second trap on the other side?
No, I'm not trying that.
Oh, okay, yeah. Deploy goblin.
Well, I'm going to continue just down the path since they don't seem to be impeding our progress past these fiery burned galaxy statues.
So you're going to stay on the path?
Yep.
Is that what I'm hearing?
Yeah.
No, we just decided we were going to go off the path or around because the path ripples burning.
Right.
I want to see this. Let her go.
I'm going to
try. I'm going to try it once more and see if something happens.
Okay, you have bardic inspiration.
I know.
This time.
Okay.
Good. Good.
I have a question.
Bardic.
Are you moving closer to her?
Hell no.
Anything whatsoever?
No.
Yes.
Safe observing distance.
Safe observing distance.
Great
goblins.
Great performance.
That's fine.
Second verse, dance first.
Yeah. actually, though, since now you're in between two of them,
oh well,
it's coming from both sides.
Excellent.
Mm. Nice.
So you need to make two.
All right.
Scary
well.
Saving throws.
Nice. That was talk about self-inflicted
wounds.
Yeah.
So I have total of 13 and 16.
That's
luckily
good.
For you, you see the squat.
Woo!
Excellent.
But it's like, oh, the fire went over my head.
Oh,
you're
goodness.
Welcome.
Mm. So they all do that, so I'm going to join you off the path. All right?
Mm-hmm.
This experimentation has been a great success.
Mm-hmm. That's how we learn.
That's how we learn.
That's right.
People think goblins not smart. Wrong.
We are. We are intelligent people.
Mm. Not good word, but yes, we are. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So you're moving around the walking on the dirt, and you actually just barely spot a section in front of you that you go, you know, that ground doesn't look very stable.
Second trap.
Yeah.
Point. Unstable ground.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, strong five eyes totally missed the one in front of him.
I was laughing at the goblin. What a fool!
So give me a dexterity saving throw.
make an effort to land on my head so it won't hurt as much.
So you only end up taking 5 damage.
A paltry sum.
Yes. Of course, the sand's now starting to fill back in.
I don't see any problems here. Actually, I see one less problem here.
It's a large
problem. Exactly. That we have. It's like when you, how did you lose 50 pounds? Well, I divorced him and left him out in the, I don't know. It's
yeah.
That's how they try to lower a rope.
Yeah, I'm sure we can rope you out of there.
We'll grab said rope.
Okay. You're going to grab said rope and you're going to pull him up?
Yeah.
I'm
going to chew you on, buddy.
I'll say this.
I'm serious. You have advantage on this?
Oh, Gronk's looking good now. That is, let's see, 21.
All right. You practically fly out of there.
Yeah, I could have used my winged boots, but I wanted to see how good they were.
Can't Earth.
Not bad. A little snappier next time, please.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I hope you never land on your head again.
So many eyes.
So many eyes. Still managed missing the...
Are the eyes, are they, is there, so you have your two, like,
well, no,
usual eyes, and then you've drawn, like, three more eyes?
I have
your
two.
Head?
When I cast spells, I put a monocle on. And
that's
one,
three.
My instructor said he was going to keep his eyes on me, so I made sure that was true. And I open up a box, and there's two eyes there.
Okay.
Cool. I don't know why you asked
me. I am very sad that I asked that question.
Backstory, too.
Backstory.
Yeah, it was.
It is a
double-edged sword.
Yep.
Double-edged sword.
Okay. Gromnum. Sphinxes. Fire through eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Cover eyes. Eyes keen. Someone cover eyes.
No, thank you.
No.
You, wise in magic, cover eyes.
I think we just need to run.
Then we walk the path safe once eyes covered.
No, I don't think so.
Grom see it. Grom feel it.
We just keep walking through the sand and watch for your shadow.
Yep. Very carefully.
Who had 10-foot pole? 11-foot, okay.
That would be much too tall.
Yes.
You know, 3.5-foot pole.
9?
That's like 3 times as tall as I am.
6-foot.
Twice as tall as I am.
5-foot pole.
Grim will be walking
almost
looking for to see if anything is similar. My passive perception is 11, but I feel like it's much better than that.
Yeah.
It's...
This group's passive perception average is 10.
Pretty low?
Yeah.
So you're saying we're not the wisest group?
No.
Need to be.
Okay.
We are. Don't need to be.
Coolsies.
Which is why it suddenly only occurs to our dear cleric when he's, even with the sphinxes,
mm-hmm.
the eyes sort of fade and go back to stone, and there's no more illusion of them tracking the group walking by.
I explained this to them.
So all we have to do is make sure that an orc strode down a hole, and then the eyes from the sphinx deactivate. I see the truth.
I took my turn.
That is pretty much you're. You're an orc too, right?
I am.
Oh yeah. We'll go in order.
Yeah.
All right. By number of eyes. You guys have the same number of eyes?
Depends on if I'm using an invocation or not.
Okay. Cool. and whoever has the most eyes at the time.
Eyes.
I don't think number of eyes problem.
No, it's
travel.
Okay, well, somebody fall into the next hole so that I can walk past.
No, falling hole not requisite. Unrelated and circumstantial.
Okay, I'm gonna get back on the path, and I'm just gonna try walking past the other.
Gronk say onomatopoeia.
Yeah.
I know, but I tell you.
Strom will go up behind one of the sphinxes and just look at it. Does it have arcane runes on it? Does it have any sort of power?
Arcane runes? No, there's some odd cut marks in it, but they don't seem to be arcane to you.
Okay.
Would
an investigation, an arcana check, be able to tell me anything?
Yeah, it will. Go ahead.
Which one?
Arcane.
Okay. 17.
You think it's some sort of arcane language that has a basis in a language you don't know?
You don't know very many languages.
You want to look at it?
Yeah, I mean, I don't have to pop open the 3 more eyes for it, but I can do it.
I want you to have as many eyes as I do.
Excellent.
So,
okay.
Go for it.
So, yes, I will join Scrum and take a look at it. pointing out the scratches, inscriptions, stuff.
It's a language, I don't know what.
And, you know, just around various parts of the forehead and, you know,
mm-hmm.
the upper part of the head. Some animal eyes just sort of peel out from under the skin.
Okay.
Well, that's gross.
And it is. It really is. So, eyes of the Roomkeeper, I can read all right.
These hieroglyphs are a version of arcane writing for in that language.
Mm-hmm.
And say, we shall protect the temple from those who are not Osiris' followers.
I mean, does have a good dental plan? Because I could be talked into it.
I can sway. So yeah, I'll relay that to the rest of the people here.
I have no strong opinion.
We have funny hat charm.
Ooh yeah, present that. Like, dude, hold it out.
Yeah,
you
go first.
Maybe we try both things. I put you on my back, looking other way.
No.
We look at.
Absolutely.
I look goblin. I'm back.
No.
You look that way. I look
no.
this way. So we
no.
look eye level, and I present a good plan.
That's
you know,
a
good
plan.
Good plan.
I do not feel it.
Grandma plan.
No.
No,
it is a grandma plan. That's why I don't feel it.
Gribble, you're half this size, you get half a vote.
I have half a vote as well.
That's right. So it's 3-1.
Alright.
Get
on that. I'm on top.
Alright, fine. I'll jump on the back of your shoulder.
Alright, so he's looking at I'm looking this way. We like side over and I'm holding the.
Yeah. And nothing happens.
Perfect. Fixed.
Keep turning around.
Let's keep going. Looks like that. Falling in a hole, looking in the eyes, boom, problem solved.
I tried looking it in the eyes, nothing go up.
And the charm, I think that.
The charm also,
that
super helpful.
That might have a little bit to do with it.
So, you walk out in front of us, like, hold it out, and just nothing bad will happen.
No, we do the same thing.
No,
it worked.
No.
Change out.
No,
it worked.
Fine.
It worked.
So which terrace are we heading towards? There was
the top.
Dead Brown Terrace, Column Terrace, Terrace with stuff we don't know yet.
Alright.
We want the temple at the top.
You want the temple's at the top.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. And what you have is three terraces with dead vegetation.
They're all dead.
I misunderstood.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a ramp going up.
It's supposed to be plenty, but that advertising.
Are there multiple, like, are there more sphinxes on the path?
No, they're just on this flat section.
Okay.
Leading up to it. So we're going to scurry along behind the charm, past the sphinxes.
Yeah.
And then
go
as fast as Mother will like carry me.
Which is not very fast, but still.
As long as you basically stay within 30 feet of our lovely cleric.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Grom, actually, I'm going to accept that offer and piggyback ride.
All right, you're on top. Carry two.
Yes.
I actually like to. It's maybe a little late in the time, but I'm gonna make a religion check about this whole Osiris plenty nonsense.
Osiris.
That's a 16.
Plenty nonsense.
Do you realize Mahalaran has its own unique pantheon, except from all the rest of the world, and because they were pulled here from another world. And Osiris was originally a god of the harvest, and then he got killed and brought back to life, and that's when he became god of the dead as well.
Oh,
you know, kind of thing.
So that's in your wheelhouse.
You don't know all the gritty details, but that's like the top view.
Best death is death you come back from.
Yes.
Grandma's
dead. I can't disagree with
that.
She
dead though.
As long as we stay within 30 feet of the amulet, the sphinxes stop trying to shoot us in the face.
Yes.
Excellent.
It's tall.
Yep.
Right.
Fireball
that's
formation.
All we have. Thanks everybody for coming.
Yep.
Right. No. That's fine.
Yes.
So you're going up the path, and then you realize it's a very easy grade, as if maybe it's designed for to pull carts up or something. And there seems to have been pipes at some point in these terraces that are flooded and
irrigation.
Yeah, there may have been actual irrigation going on at some point, but not any time recent. go up past three of those, and you come to this big corridor.
Mm-hmm.
And it's got pillars all around. It's an open air courtyard, 50 feet by 50 feet kind of place. Each of the columns look like a human in some sort of form of a harvester. You know, they have a scythe, they're holding a bushel of grain, but it's definitely all thematically linked that way. And there are a few scorch marks here and there.
Okay.
And at the far end where the starts to go back up, there's a canopy kind of tent with open sides,
okay,
and a woman sitting on it and some pillows sort of resting there, and two men in light robes apparently preparing a small meal for her. Hello. Closer, child.
Oh, last time I did that, I got burned. You're not going to burn me, right?
Oh, no. Why did I do that?
I would like to receive her attention to you.
Okay. You can try.
Yeah, this isn't going to go well, I'm sure. That's a seven.
No, I mean, yeah, that's a seven.
Well, you're...
I have no reason to go to the channel. I'm just like this natural.
Right. No reason whatsoever.
She seems nice. I'm gonna go up and talk to mom. Also, those pillows look small.
Not mine.
You're a little important.
Did you?
You sent her home?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, that's the best way to go when you're talking to ladies. Oh.
Well, I thought wingman was important. Grandpa said.
I left those at home. I don't have any.
Always
home.
Always home.
Not right now.
No wings yet. So who are you, child, that comes to this place of worship?
I am Greta Gooch of the Gooch clan from Schultz. I traveled very, 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 very far.
Yes, you have.
I don't even know how far. It's a lot. It's a big number.
Yes.
And I've brought my friend Grimble and the rest of these people.
I like how she did that.
And are you here to worship your partner?
We're here to I got a letter and I forgot why we're here, actually.
I hold this up in my back.
But yes, we are here to pay respects. We're not here to burn the temple.
Nope.
Yes.
Definitely not.
Not that.
Not that.
I have that written down. Don't burn a temple. I wrote
it
in my It's
very hard to burn a temple that's built out of stone.
Oh, we're stubborn.
Stranger things have happened.
Those pillows go up real nice, though.
We're not burning
it. No, we can't burn it. But boy, if we could, that would be real fun.
Unless it had a tag. I think if the tag can't burn.
Yeah.
Okay. If you tear the tag off, then you have to burn it.
Yeah.
Claire?
Yes?
Gribble would, while this fascinating conversation going on, is going to use one of his shadow sorcerer abilities to cast detect thoughts on the nice lady. So he will kind of sidle up within 30 feet, and if she could please make a wisdom save for DC 15.
17 on the die.
Poop. let me see if she detects that.
Does it go into the brain part?
Okay, into the brain.
Two steps
down. Okay, so you initially learn surface thoughts. So what are? And I just saw that as soon as you said it. I'm a terrible player. What are the surface thoughts of this creature? Just surface thoughts.
Just
things bubbling to the top.
She's probably thinking that we're idiots.
No, she's wondering how well you would taste.
Right, that's pretty solid.
Oh,
I sometimes wonder that myself.
See,
Screamy.
So now that I have the surface thought that I've detected is, how does this goblin taste?
It doesn't. She didn't identify it as a goblin. She's a creature.
Oh.
She has no idea
oh.
what this creature is in front of
her. She wants to know how things taste. Well, that, as the conversation continues then.
Not like chicken.
Kind of like chicken.
No, not like chicken.
A little like chicken. Is going to, one moment please, I believe I have the ability to use telepathy in a limited capacity.
I know, it's pretty cool. It is pretty cool.
It was under your languages, yes.
So I share a language with you. Dearest Jenny.
Yes.
You are going to hear Grimble's voice kind of inserted into your brain, telling you, please be careful, she's thinking about what we taste like. Don't, just keep it right, like nothing's going on. Blink, no, Blink. Excuse me. But be aware, I'm talking in your brain. But be aware that she wants to know how we taste. You should back away slowly.
You take like a half step back.
Where are you going, Chuck?
Tell her nowhere.
I was gonna go grab the drink because the pillows look comfortable.
Okay, that works too. Just keep getting away.
You want to sit on the pillow? Come sit on the pillow.
No, I would not do that at all for you. Transition to kind of like the back here.
Dirt.
Psst, dirt.
Mm.
That lady wants to eat us, I'm pretty sure. You don't get to eat, you get no more tips because you ignore me. This is directly dirt specifically. She was thinking about, don't ask me how I know, but she was thinking about how we might taste.
No, when you do this, does it come across with your usual tone?
Yeah, it comes across with my usual usual voice. Just
not,
in your
not
brain.
The first time I've heard voices in my head, so I'm not entirely thrown off by this. But
this is a thing I can do. I didn't mention that before. Sorry.
Mm.
But I think this can be lost. Yes.
Lean over to.
Now, there we go. See? Now we start the.
Yeah.
And then
just the
last
one.
Okay.
You're doing it mentally?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's not the reaction I'm going for.
Oh. That would be bad then. Okay.
The firebolts for us.
It's true.
I'm
going
to take a little seat and ask her to tell me more about this firebolt. Okay.
Oh my god.
Sit down.
Whatever.
Excuse me, my fur. Then it does the soft. This seems wrong. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I'm from the jungle. We don't have pillows.
Okay.
But. Does it feel warm though, an animal alive? Like, I think your pillow's breathing.
Well, perhaps that's because it's not really pillow.
Aha! Oh my gosh, I'm sitting on a creature. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry.
Yes, sitting on me, and a claw comes out. Drops the illusion, and basically you're looking at
oh my.
So all right. Well, I can't dodge that because I'm just sitting on her butt. So okay.
Yeah.
Be careful! I heard they spit. For every time I heard that.
Okay, so that's right. 22.
Yeah, no, absolutely, all day. Armor classes.
Take 14 slashing damage.
Oh dear me.
Oh, this pillow, it hurts.
Well, she's kind of large, and she's got these big claws.
Yeah, let's see. Then I would like to do my nimble escape then upon this and disengage.
All right, and then we'll do initiative.
Sounds like
sure.
All right, so I'm gonna take that one.
You're the boss.
Pillow hurts, don't recommend. Also, 0 stars.
Zero stars. Do not recommend.
I thought you said this was going to be a restful vacation.
Shawn, what's your initiative?
That would be a 13.
All right.
Ooh, nice.
And Dirk?
9.
Great. Right up.
I got 21.
Wow.
No longer resembles like a nice older lady. It now is like half woman, half lion,
yeah.
And large.
She was
and
lion,
large.
Yes.
She
was
wild.
Right.
Okay. Then
that's better.
Grimble is going to look at the Lamia.
The Lamia, and I would like it very much if she would make an intelligence saving throw DC 15.
Well, you wanted her to make it?
No, I do not. I would like her to attempt a DC 15 intelligence saving
she
throw.
She failed.
Hooray! Hey. This makes Grimble so happy.
None of us is good at things, it's not me.
So she will take 11 points of psychic damage.
Okay.
And she cannot take a reaction until the end of her next turn. Moreover, quote, on its next turn, the Lamia must choose whether it gets a move, an action, or a bonus action. It only gets one.
Okay.
Penalty box.
Nice. Well done.
Greta?
Well, she hurt me, so now that I've disengaged and scooted away from her a bit, I'm going to throw a firebolt at her because I'm angry.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm angry.
Because I'm angry. I am going to... Oh, nope, I did not take that. That meant a man. So, I'm just going to throw a firebolt at her.
Okay.
And then I'm going to quick get a second one. Next level on section. All right. Ooh, so the first firebolt, I know how to do magic here, is 19 to hit.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
And second is 20 to hit.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent.
She's not wearing anything armorish, so.
No, she's made out of fur.
You're made out of fur.
You're made out of fur.
Convention ready.
Here. All right, so that is 10 and 23.
Okay.
Oh wait. I have elemental adept, none of those were ones, so I don't have to reroll any of them.
Okay.
Or treat them too.
All right.
She's
pretty
was
hurt.
Resistant, she wouldn't be.
However, her two friends are not going to just stand there and let you attack her.
I assumed as much.
So, they're going to pull their scimitars. And
I may have made a minor
miscalculation. A boo-boo.
Yeah.
Math was never my strong point, Grimble.
And
boo-boo.
I'm the best at magic.
Okay, so I'm quite positive that a simple 15? No, a 6 and a
no.
And a 14.
Those both miss.
Those both miss. However, since we have pack tactics optioning, and the other one gets
must we?
Yes, must we? The 22
yes.
Hit,
yes.
Right?
No, yeah. I'll allow it.
Oh yes, well that's 5 slashing damage then.
Okay. Ow! This was a sharp tooth.
Strumb, 5 eyes.
Ooh.
It's a little difficult to, well, Yeah, keeping her out of it, unless you have some method of shaping it. Yeah, they're basically on either side of her getting their little pack tactics
in.
Then
can I get one of them in the
lock? Yes.
Okay. I was going to hit me with the lightning bolt.
Same.
Okay. That will be the Lamia, and this will be the other one. There's 17s on the dice.
Claire, come on. Yeah.
Come on, Claire.
I'm sorry, I'm using my nice new dice. So. 12. The person attacking Greta looks pretty darn crispy. Still standing, but not by much. Yes, the Lamia is also looking pretty darn crispy.
Excellent. I wonder if she tastes like chicken.
I think she tastes like lion.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what that
is. Well, since she can only do one thing.
Yep. Just the one thing.
There's now multiple Lamias there.
Oh, ooh. Dear me.
She did a mirror image thing.
Wise. Very one. Very, very crafty. Hmm.
Dearth?
The damaged guy with the scimitar.
Mm-hmm.
The con save is equal to frost that's arcing out of my head.
I think that? 18 on the die.
Yeah. It was worth a shot.
Yeah. Nice die. Grom.
Grom, speak words grandma teach long ago. And I bless those three.
Okay.
Nope.
Woo! Woohoo! Is that it?
Us three.
Yeah.
All right.
I'll move up.
You move up. Okay.
I'm gonna put my bless die over here. Otherwise, I'm gonna forget it.
Grimble.
Yeah. So the two gentlemen wielding scimitars.
Mm-hmm.
Are they adjacent to one another?
No, they're on either side.
They're
of
on either side of you. Is one of them adjacent to the Lamia?
Yes.
Okay.
That's how they managed to get
in the lightning bolt configuration. All right.
Mm-hmm.
So Grimble is going to take out, he's going to like unsling his lute, and he's going to play like a Captain Beefheart tune at the scimitar gentleman who is adjacent to the Lamia, and I would love it if he would make me a wisdom saving throw, please.
Okay.
Please.
16
on the dice.
That's my mate, so I would attempt. Okay.
Who? He has succeeded in resisting my crown of madness. I will continue playing the song anyway. And as a bonus action. No.
Hide.
No, I don't want to.
But then you can be surprising.
Sing me song, Goblin.
Is there anything I can hide behind?
Not really.
Okay. See? Told you. Then, as a bonus action, I will give Bardic Inspiration to. No. No. Yes, the gentleman on the end. He threw a lightning bolt. That's badass. You just threw a firebolt. By the way, with this Bardic Inspiration, you can use it as normal, where it improves a saving throw attack roll. Or if you cast a damaging or healing spell, which you have been known to do, because I just saw it, you can add that d6 to your damage.
Ooh,
or your healing.
Fancy.
Thank you.
Okay, Greta?
All right. Wow, I don't like these two people touching me.
Like touching you with swords. That's an important thing to.
I'm going to twin cast Shocking Grasp and attack each of them.
Nice.
Okay.
Right.
Nice.
So the one on my left. That's 17 plus numbers.
Yeah, that hits.
Shocking Grasp is number 8,
D8. D8.
Three. and then 12 plus 6 is 18.
Yes, that hits.
All right.
They're not obviously wearing any kind of armor.
Yeah, I mean, you know, but they can't take the reaction, so that's important. Mm-hmm. What's that? All right, 1. Down at 1 lightning damage.
Okay.
Woo. Oh, wait, I'm fifth level. I get to do...
You get to do 2
dice on each one. Plus 7 on the one on my left, plus 3 on the one.
Okay, so the one on your left dies.
Yeah! Yay. I am an excellent attacker of the things as well, Grimble.
I'm so All proud right. of you. I'm so proud of you.
Somebody's proud of me.
So the remaining one is a little annoyed at you.
Yeah, absolutely. I think so.
Give me a wisdom saving throw.
Don't forget your bless.
Oh, yes. Yes, definitely remember my bless. Yes.
Never
All right.
forget the bless.
That's 12 plus not very much. Other one over there. That's 12.
Okay, so you did not succumb to their gaze attack.
Yeah.
Strom, Five Eyes, you're up.
They didn't look down low enough.
As much as I would like to blow something up, I think I'm going to cast a spell magic on Melamia to get rid of her many images.
Okay.
And well then played, I get sir. To take that energy and use it later.
Well
All right.
Played.
Oh, yeah. There they go. Which is she finds annoying.
I've been known.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm still standing near her, everyone. She stopped moving.
And I no longer have that restriction on actions, right?
Gone.
That's all gone.
That Lamia's operational.
Yes, she is.
What's wrong?
That Lamia is fully operational.
So she'll go ahead and attack you with her claw and her dagger. Yes,
yeah.
You're right there.
I know.
And you're
she can't
little.
Reach anybody else. And somehow, or however, let's see, with the claw, that's a 16, and with the dagger, that's a 15.
The 16 hits.
The 16 hits. So that's another 14 damage, slashing damage.
Oof. I'm starting to feel slightly injured.
Dearth.
So I'm going to do the frosting again, this time at the other remaining human.
Okay. Remaining human seeming.
Human seeming, yes. The
human.
Jerk with the scimitar.
Okay.
So Constitution saving throw.
I like my dice.
I'm going to give up.
Go bite him next time.
I'm just trying to preserve a meal for later.
Grom, 2 eyes.
Oh, Grom smelled death in air. This Osiris amulet, powerful. Is the one next to the Lamia still there?
No, that's
that
the
one
that died.
Died. That one died? Oh, too bad.
The one
dead.
Next to me is. Also the Lamia.
Can I reach the Lamia?
Sure, if you take your full movement, you can reach there.
Okay, I will move up to the Lamia, and I'll say, it death time, death woman.
It's death time,
okay.
Death woman.
And I used the Bardic Inspiration. Oh, I don't have Bardic.
I love that song. Death Time, Death Woman.
Ah, famous.
Ronnie James Dio.
That looks like a pretty good 22.
Yeah, that'll hit.
And I'm going to dump some pain into her. That is going to be.
Other
good song.
Place your hand in the box.
No.
14. So that is 14 necrotic, and then I'm going to add another 21 points of necrotic if necessary.
Damn!
Touch of death.
Ooh. Man, I should.
Well, she's not dead, so if you're going to add the other points.
Yeah, 21.
Is she now dead?
21?
Yeah.
No.
Ooh.
No.
Powerful.
You're close.
Wowzers. Oh, schnauzers. That was.
Bigger death? Much
but that, I mean, you did 14 and then 21.
Yeah.
Yeah. And she still has
so higher than second level, I guess.
You inflicted the hell out of her, man.
She's gonna inflict well.
Grimble. Wow.
Grimble is gonna look in awe at the like he touches
energy.
Her and she starts like being unmade by this necrotic energy. Man, that is impressive. Good stuff. However, I'm gonna kind of look over at Gertie,
Greta.
Sup.
Sup. And do a little riff, and you're going to feel slightly better, because I don't want you to die yet, to the tune of 7 points of healing from healing word.
Okay. Every little bit helps.
And it does. Every little bit. That's the healing. It's not really my thing. Yeah. And then Grimble is going to play another riff and make eye contact with Alamia, and I would like her to make me an intelligence saving throw.
Okay.
To attempt an intelligence saving throw.
Fail.
What?
The wording, it matters.
Yeah. So that was a mind sliver, so like a disorienting blast of psychic energy strikes her for 8 points of psychic damage.
She staggers but is still there. Oh.
Then guess what? She will subtract 1d4 from the next saving throw she makes before the end of my next turn.
Okay. Cool.
She's disoriented.
She's disoriented.
On the ropes.
On the ropes. The head of the gentleman who's been attacking you.
Oh, no, he's not a human.
Mm. Turns into that of a jackal.
Oh,
and he bites
snap.
You.
Oh, good.
Must he? Well, apparently, maybe not.
This area's lousy with jackal wares, I tell you.
14 misses, doesn't it?
14 misses. It
okay.
Pains
wrong
to be short
with you.
Sometimes.
I don't know.
Yes.
I'm a little
down
punchy.
Here, buddy.
Strum.
I'm going to serve her a menu of scorching rays.
Ooh.
We're going to start with the appetizer.
Okay.
and the bless. Much appreciated.
Yeah.
Don't forget, you got bardic inspiration too,
eight,
buddy.
An 8, 16.
16 will hit.
Okay, so that will be 2d6. I will use the bardic inspiration, and plus I will channel the magic that she was using that I drained away for 4 more points.
Ooh.
So we have.
Cunningly played, sir.
8, 13 plus 4 is 17. 17 fire damage.
17 fire damage, and we have cooked Lamia.
Yeah.
Excellent.
I wonder what she tastes
what
like.
What does it taste like?
I will take the other two rays and put them into the jackal-headed gentleman.
Okay.
I no longer have that. Oh, I still have the bless, though.
Yeah, you're still
funny how that works. That is a very high number.
Okay.
That is 7 points of fire.
Okay.
The last bolt is a 22.
Yeah.
That is 9 points of fire.
Just enough.
Yay!
Hooray!
Jackal
Appetizers has cooked
Lamia
the jackalware.
I would like
nice.
To try to taste the Lamia just to see if it tastes like chicken.
Gross.
What?
It. I'm just saying.
You can't say. You can't say you've never eaten anything gross. I'm not eating the jackal though.
Oh, because that's a bridge too far. The half lady, half lion, completely acceptable, possibly delicious.
Ew, he has the jackal head, bro.
Yeah.
No, I like dogs.
Jackals aren't dogs. Anyway, I'm just being smart ass or something.
Please
taste
to
away.
Bison.
All things can be eaten.
Oh, it tastes like bison.
Yeah. It tastes like bison. That's amazing.
This meat is really lean.
It's real easy to overcook it because the fat content is so low. Sorry.
Do you have opinions?
I have very strong.
I was hoping it would be like chicken. Oh well. Sorry. That's
oh,
fine.
Now looting stage begin. Goblins.
Yeah, we might. Whoa.
Yeah, what do they have?
Whoa. Grimble will take a look around for stuff, but not because your ass said so, but because he wants to do it.
Of course. Free will important.
That's right.
Greta is looking because she has suffered greatly, not because you asked me to.
Mm. I've already looted the whole place and I'm on my way out. Just kidding. I'm still looting the place.
If you wish, spend 10 minutes. Apply a heal. Or I can give snack.
Which one helps more?
Well, you like eating weird things. Snack, pretty off.
Okay.
It's moose guts stuffed in...
Translation, prayer of healing or chef temporary hit points.
Oh.
I'll pick the prayer of healing. Seems like we're
gonna... All right, I'll spend 10 minutes.
We're
and
gonna
anybody,
stand here and loot.
Anybody
yeah.
who wants it can
well,
get some healing.
Oddly enough, in among their objects, there are things you find,
excited.
Like 5 more of those. in a bag.
Oh. I'm going to put one on.
And gold, about 20 pieces of gold.
We got our souvenir necklaces.
And 12 potions of healing.
Oh, my God.
There you go.
In other words, they already looted.
Oh, some
the
acolytes.
Oh, the acolyte, the poor acolytes. You know what? Worked out for us, though.
Yep.
So, you know, I'm feeling pretty good. I didn't say all of us. I just us, as in everybody but you. I would like to point out, I told you clearly in
like
your little nugget to not go over there. And you're like, I'm going to have a seat. And
I would like to point out that I was listening to you.
I know. you're your own goblin, and I respect that.
You drink potions.
Yeah, I'm drinking potions.
So Grimble's going to take out, like, he has a bevy, a plethora of holy symbols. And he is going to add that one too, but like wear that one outside, tuck the rest. It's like the dude from The Mummy, like the little mummy dude.
Yeah.
Just like that. He's like, well, this might come in handy. So yeah, cool.
I gave everybody a snack of questionable meat. Everybody received 3 temporary hit points.
Oh, well, thank you, buddy.
So we did not do the prayer of healing.
I don't care what Grom says. Yeah. You're okay.
It's spicy.
Ooh. Okay. All right. That's close.
Yeah. They were only potions of healing because, I mean, they were acolytes. They weren't going to get extra stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Make stuff.
Ooh.
Yep.
All right. I drank 3 potions of healing, and I feel much better now.
Good stuff.
Okay. Good stuff. They don't taste like bison.
No, they don't.
They taste
like bison urine.
They taste like sparkles.
Don't knock it till you try.
I was going to say it tastes like medicine. Ooh, effervescent. I like it.
I learned that word somewhere, and I think I used it correctly, right?
You did, actually.
Yeah.
So you deal with the remains of the jackalware and Lamia, and have an idea maybe of partly of what happened to them.
They ate everyone.
Yeah. And you come to the final entrance to the temple, where again you have pillars that resemble harvesters of various types, and huge stone doors with gold engravings on them.
Ooh.
Can you read these?
Yes.
Well, gold engravings of
hieroglyphs.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, those are fine. Those don't mean anything.
I mean, if you count that as a form of writing, then
yes, it is a form of writing.
Form of writing before, it hasn't changed.
Yes.
It might be art now.
It might be art now. Yes, no, it is definitely a language, and it basically says, welcome to the terraces of plenty. Stored here is the fruit of the harvest for times when the harvest is not as plentiful.
Mm-hmm. Oh, like those terraces outside that were all shriveled and withered and not bountiful.
Mm-hmm.
I bet there's fruit in here. We probably should not eat it.
Unless metaphor. It dangerous eat metaphor.
What is a metaphor?
Not sure.
It's one less than a meta 5.
Yep.
That makes sense. Mm-hmm.
A metaphor is like a simile.
What?
That was stupid. I'm sorry.
I'm playing with nerds.
English major humor.
Ah, yes. Can you tell we all do way too much writing?
Yeah.
So, open the doors.
I can't. They're really big. Somebody else has to do this.
There isn't like an obvious place that the symbol would insert or anything like that.
Hold on. Wand. Fidgeting, detect magic.
Nothing magical currently on the doors.
No magic on the doors. I'm pretty sure we're safe. What?
Do you have the spell to open the doors so we don't have to touch them?
Oh, let me think about it. Grimble will again like unlimber his lute and play like the brown note, and that's knock.
Okay.
Doors
open.
Oh, I don't like when you do that.
No, it sounds horrible. DC 15, charisma saving throw, or you poo in your pants.
Okay, so the doors open into a fairly large area. I mean, it's not.
Do we see any fruit?
Hmm? No, you don't see any fruit right away. What you do see is a space with very nice tile floor and doors off to two sides and a lot of scratch marks on the floor. There's double doors in front of you and doors to either side that are also double doors, not as small, a little bit smaller. But
Grom inspect scratch marks, try to figure out what are.
There's a lot of doors as well, more doors than I expected.
Do you want survival? Do you want, yeah, what kind of check do you want?
Investigation.
I'm probably bad at any of it, but hey, that's a 15.
I'm not good at that.
I got a 16.
Okay. You get the feeling that at some point there was things in this room. And someone or something moved them without taking care of the floor, furniture or statues, whatever. And as you're just looking at them, it looks like all the scratch marks eventually end up going through the double doors opposite the opening.
Should we go through the obvious doors or the less obvious doors?
The obvious doors. Clearly, it's
obvious doors.
Obviously.
It's a path.
The obvious choice.
Oh, it is a path.
It's a path.
We follow the path.
Okay. You go into, it seems to be, instead of a nice big square, you've got a long room. It's only 20 feet deep. There's still some nice tiles on the floor. Mm. There's doors, the walls angled on either end, and there's doors in the middle of that, and there's a door in front of you.
We don't see any furniture.
Again, you don't see furniture, you see scratch marks.
Follow the path.
But scratch marks are going all towards the center door.
I'm good for the center door then.
Okay.
Very strange.
Follow the scratches.
Okay.
It's a path.
Follow the path of scratches.
Scratch path.
You first.
Okay.
If I remember.
Somebody still has to open the door. They look heavy.
Goblin, move up.
No. What? Open the door.
Who,
I'm
me?
Try you. To open the door.
Okay. I open door.
It opens.
Okay. I'm going to go through the door.
Yeah.
Okay. There's a dark hallway. And you, if I remember correctly, you all do have dark vision. So
dark
it doesn't
vision.
Really bother you that much.
Yes.
But the fact that this is dark and about 60 feet long before it opens up in another larger area.
Is there anything on the wall?
No.
Follow it.
But it's a path.
It's a path.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's go down to the big room.
You go down to the big room.
Did we find the furniture?
Well, sort of, kind of. There's this big, huge pile of furniture, statuary, gold, gems, jewels. Huge pile on the far side of the room. The room is 50 feet deep.
Mm-hmm.
And 80 feet wide, and there's an alcove in the back about 40 feet wide, and this pile is in front of that alcove, and it looks like there might be another small niche area behind that. And looking to your right, you see a lot of boxes and barrels in sort of stacked haphazardly, and to your left is a large pile of bones. I'm talking it's about 15 feet tall and 20 by 10 by 10. You know, it's a large area of bones.
Is it just like mishmashed bones? Or
mishmashed.
Like,
bones. Okay.
Grimble, correct me if I'm wrong.
Yes.
That seems like a bad thing to find bones.
I'm going to say, and I'm just spitballing here, that a very large pile of bones is not what we wanted to see. I was hoping for gold, jewels, precious items.
Well, you had people.
It's, well, that's all in front of us.
Yes.
The pile of bones is because people can't live off treasure alone, so they got what they deserved. It's fine.
Okay.
I think they were eaten.
Well, yeah, I mean, if they were trying to eat gold and gems and stuff, then it serves
sense.
Them right.
We already determined they were eaten.
By the Lamia.
Well, there's
by
that.
By the bison-tasting Lamia.
The bison-tasting Lamia.
So you're all in the room now?
Yeah.
No,
yes.
We're all there.
Yes.
About to get...
The door doesn't shut behind us.
Rochambeau'd.
No, the door doesn't shut behind you. It's 60 feet behind you.
Okay.
And you hear a whoomp.
Wasn't me.
Whoomp.
That's probably a threatening sound.
And from behind that huge pile of furniture, gems, and jewels.
Yes.
You find something sort of.
A teddy bear.
Teddy bear, yeah. I think not.
Okay.
Well, okay then.
They said sadly.
I wonder if I'm related to you.
Think that kobold.
Yeah.
Maybe your grandma.
So what you're saying, Claire, is a dragon rears its head up from behind the jewels and gold that we wanted to take.
Yes.
So I say.
And basically considers you to be invaders.
What? We just came out to say hi.
Greetings, oh my dear one.
Okay. So you two will be odd. You three will be.
Accurate.
Even.
Feels personal. Accurate.
So the three of you get lightning breath at you.
Of course we do.
Okay.
That's a whole thing. Give me some saving throws.
It sucks to be you.
Yeah, it's pretty cool over here.
We still have our bless.
Oh, no. We do still have bless,
safe
right?
space.
You we still have bless.
It doesn't help me. I rolled a two.
Claire, could I cast Absorb Elements?
As a reaction?
Yeah.
Sure.
Excellent.
If it's a reaction kind of
it
thing.
It is one reaction.
One
which
reaction.
You can take if acid, cold, fire, lightning, or thunder,
or
this table. Comes at you.
at you, yes.
I absorb 15 points of table damage.
The DC is 16. Yeah. For the saving throw for lightning.
Yeah, I didn't get that.
I'm glad I only drink three of our potions. I'm going to need to drink the rest.
The rest of them popped when they got hit by the lightning.
They bubbled.
Don't be funny like that.
We're not in that edition.
Darn it!
Sorry.
I'm actually really happy we're
she
not.
Didn't say yet.
Yeah.
She's still rolling.
No, we're not in that condition.
She's got to roll all of the dice first to tell us how dead we are.
Carry the 7.
Yep.
Two. We'll just do the average. So 55.
No!
Half it if you made the save.
Don't forget your 3 temporary hit points.
Yes.
Feel like 52.
Ouch.
Yeah.
Greta suddenly looks like this was a poor choice.
Wowie.
Yeah.
Hey, I probably won't recharge it.
Well, now that you've said that, it will absolutely recharge.
Uh-huh.
Great.
I have a good track record of recharging it.
Mm. Thanks
a
lot.
Yep, you
since you cheat, yes.
My God!
It's a joke!
Ladies and gentlemen, Shawn Merwin.
I would flip the table, but I'm too weak.
Consider it flipped.
You just, in my mind, I'm doing something very heroic right now.
I think we need some initiatives.
No.
That is
a thing we can do.
Initiative
run out of the room. You're running out of the room? Is what I'm hearing?
That is taking initiative.
Yeah.
Is it coward?
I still want initiative for that.
Oh, yeah.
Because there's no guarantee that the dragon's by itself.
Yeah.
Oh,
I still have a good initiative.
Greta.
19.
All right. Grimble.
15.
Dearth.
19.
Dearth, do you want to go before Greta or let Greta go first?
Oh, I'll give it a shot.
Okay.
Let me go.
Grom.
No.
Oh, you're going to
I'm going to fire up a spell that won't work.
Storm.
13.
Again.
Storm. Yes, consistently bad.
Storm. Hey, no, that would be Grom. Okay, so.
True.
Fair enough.
You're the cleric, though.
Yeah.
You can be bad in everything.
We see.
Except
we see who died first.
Except healing us. You're great at that. Great at that. Right? Bringing us back from the dead, you're also great at that.
Okay.
It's important to know.
Okay. Luckily for them,
yeah.
The lightning that comes out of the wall. What?
Oh, it's
there
you.
Is entirely too much lightning in this building. God damn it. What?
You're using up all of ours.
Yeah, that's fine. You're not using them. Somebody has to.
These things, you don't want to waste them.
No.
No.
So, give me a DC 15 dexterity saving throw.
I guess.
Dexterity.
Come on,
Claire. Dexterity,
yes. We all know how good clerics are at their dexterity.
Can I use my insight?
Specifically says dexterity on the page.
To make an intimidation check against
the
lightning.
That's a DC. You're going to scare the lightning around you?
Up to 20.
Okay.
I got a 20, but flipping air. Just because I also have a 20.
So you're only going to take 5 damage.
I am so excited. We didn't
oh, we cooking over here. It's very difficult.
No, I will tell
you.
I am fully prepared.
Oh, burning.
Oh, this is just as worse as what you had to go through.
I am fully prepared for my spell to not work.
Oh, no, I have not.
But I'm going to attempt to banish the dragon before I heroically advance in reverse.
Okay.
It's called fighting in another direction.
Extreme rare point.
And the save for that is?
Not high.
Okay.
Negligible.
It's called panic spell casting.
Are you also advancing?
And that's, I'm sorry, I don't remember quite off the top of my head. What's that against?
Charisma, right?
Yes.
Charisma? Okay.
Yeah, dragons aren't charismatic.
Oh, charisma.
At all.
So that makes it a 15 on.
Oh, you're good. Okay. That's what I assumed. I'm still going to advance my way out that door.
On the way out the door?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We run.
I'm horrifically injured.
Grimble, you want to go?
Wait. Greta.
No, it's yeah.
All right, I'm gonna grab Grimble's hand, and we're gonna dimension door.
Oh, goblin buddies!
Yay!
Okay.
Just back to a safe distance. So
wait,
I can
isn't there like
potions.
A long hallway?
Yeah, 60 foot.
We don't want to go down a long.
Oh, crap.
We not go long hall. Long
sure
hall
did.
Bad.
I sure did. I just dimensioned door to the opposite end of the hallway. Thank you.
Don't you wish you were a sorcerer?
On the opposite side of the door, even.
Okay. So luckily for you, I did not recharge my breath.
Whee!
Luckily for everyone who's still in there.
We've got this.
No, actually, it would have done you, because it's a nice straight line.
Oh, yes. How far does it go?
All the way.
Well, it's fine, so it can fly up over its thing and come close enough. It's on its turn.
It's a bad thing.
Instead...
That seems like cheating.
I told you.
I'm just going to be invisible.
Okay. Okay, you two dimension doored that away.
All
you're down that away.
All the way down past this door where we dimension
doored. Okay.
We can't even see it.
What, why are you looking at me? I mean, I'm.
It's going to fly towards you.
Because you're so delicious.
And,
it tastes like chicken.
I want no part of this.
Okay. And so we'll do.
No, it don't taste good, no.
Two claws and a bite.
Okay.
Orange are the claws.
The old claw bite.
The bite was a 1.
Oh,
so
both claws were
1. claws is a 25 and a 21.
All right. I'm going to allow those for role playing reasons.
Okay.
Because scars are cool.
So 12 each, so 24 total damage, slashing.
That leaves a little bit of a sting.
Yeah, that's right.
And it did not land, it just did that from
flying
right
after.
Above you.
Okay.
So flying after us.
Okay, and popping out from the boxes
is
a kobold.
Oh, they're nice. I like them.
I'll take the kobold. You take the dragon.
Good thing you said that, because a kobold fires a firebolt at you.
Mm-hmm. I thought you said fire.
Con save.
Okay.
And I used my reaction already, so I will stand there and take it right in the face.
That's like a whole 7 damage.
I got a 20.
Oh, okay.
A con, yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, that makes
20.
A con. Yeah, that makes, yeah. Yeah, that saves. Grimble!
How far are we now from the all of the bad things that are happening to everybody that is
We're
not
down here,
a goblin?
Down here?
Okay.
At the end of this hallway.
Roughly how many feet is that?
60.
The hallway is 60 feet.
Okay. And how far away is, say, the dragon?
The dragon's about 80 feet.
80 feet. Grimble.
Because you all didn't go that far.
No, we didn't go that far.
I wasn't sure.
Grimble's going to give Gretis a big kick
but
on the
to
forehead.
Me.
Yes.
And then jog up 20 feet so that he can, you know, kind of make out the see the dragon clearly, play kind of a Dio stinger on his lute. And
it's a good drink, the Dio stinger.
The Dio stinger. and I would like the dragon to make a DC 15. To attempt a DC 15 intelligence saving throw.
Well, that probably was a great change of thing because I rolled a 1.
No. Do you have like savey throw stuff on your dragon that can like?
Well, no, it's not that old.
Okay, good.
I am.
I mean, if you want, I can use.
I just you know.
No.
Hail.
I want to play it straight up. I want to win. I want to earn this win.
Shut your mouth.
Taylor. I'm earning this death.
I mean,
yes, you are.
I understand that you're a death cleric, but I don't need that gospel right
to
now.
Observe.
So the dragon will take 7 points of psychic damage.
Okay.
Then I'm going to quicken. Yeah. The beauty of being a sorcerer. I am going to quicken my old pal, the mind whip. Would you like a cool quip? So the dragon on this saving throw will have a, oh sweet, -4 on the saving throw from the mind sliver.
Yes.
And now the mind whip, please attempt. DC 15 intelligence saving throw on -4.
Okay. Well, if it hadn't been for that -4, we might have made it.
Aww.
Yes.
Strategery for the win.
Yeah.
So
I don't understand what is that.
you will learn. The dragon will incur 13 points of psychic damage.
Uh-huh.
It cannot take reactions until the end of its next turn.
Okay.
And on its next turn, it gets to choose an action, move, do a bad thing, or a bonus action, but only one of those.
Okay.
And I like this.
That, yeah.
This is super helpful, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Thanks, Grimble.
Storm!
I'm helpful.
Bye, guys.
Could I possibly get both the dragon and the kobold in a vitriolic sphere, so 20-foot radius?
No.
All right. So I'm glad we got to talk that over.
Yep, good job.
the sorcerer is over here with the boxes.
Okay.
The dragon's over here, so.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to focus on the dragon then.
I'm sorry.
Vitriolic sphere on the dragon.
We've
okay.
given it false confidence.
Yeah.
And
I'll do it behind the dragon, so.
So it's not
right. If that is possible.
Yeah, it's a little tricky, but
sure.
I'm tricky.
But
so
I've seen your intelligence score. You can do that.
Okay, perfect. Oh, no. Not the character, me myself.
Yeah, yeah.
Dexterity saving throw.
No,
or
if it was
16.
You, or then never mind.
What's that?
Never mind. Nothing.
Nothing. DC 16 dexterity saving throw.
Okay. Alrighty.
Dexterity
saving throw. That would be an 18. So.
18. It made it save. It takes half damage.
Okay.
So half of 25 would be 12.
Yeah.
Acid. And it does not take more damage at the end of its next turn because it made it save.
Right.
And then I will rush screaming at the kobold as my move.
Intimidation.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
In Orc, I'm screaming, so it sounds horrible, but I'm really screaming. Oh my god, why am I doing this?
Consequences of my actions.
So, you're right in front of the others, the kobold now,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Oh yeah, right up.
Mm-hmm. And so his buddy comes out.
Nice.
And attacks you.
Wait, the kobold has a buddy?
The kobold
you
has
know
a goblin.
The kobold has a buddy.
Would you like to introduce me to your friend?
Say hello to
he's the buddy's using a shield, leather armor, and he has a spear.
Turd.
He brought his bodyguard.
Nice.
And
that was a poor move on my part then.
Yeah.
I did ask why you were doing it.
Yeah, I did.
So he has advantage on the attacks because of pack attacks. So that means the 21 on the first attack.
That is definitely going to hit.
And however, the other one is a mere 11.
11 will definitely not hit.
Yeah.
Even me.
Even you. So that is 4 piercing damage.
Okay.
Because he still has his shield on. Because you guys seem to might be good.
Don't
you know? He's not, no.
I look around.
He's not going to drop the shield and go two-handed quite yet.
Okay.
It's my turn. All right. Grom feels much death in this place.
Yeah.
I use Grandma's teachings and I pull those spirits, causing them to rise in the form of spirit guardians, whipping around this area. So they.
I've done
that earlier. You were busy running and I was confused. So yeah, I will designate my friends as friends.
So just me then.
And including goblins. And so the first time on a turn or they start their turn in here, they must make a wisdom saving throw. My DC is 14 and they will take necrotic damage.
Okay. And that's the area around you is how large?
This is a 15-foot radius.
15-foot radius.
So if I need to move, you know, around the dragon to sort of be like getting more kobolds,
yeah,
I will do so.
Yeah, you're gonna have to move over a little bit
to get them
mm-hmm. them in. Okay.
Yep.
You hear noise in the bones, as if they're rattling, as if there's something underneath them.
Oh, I sense evil DM at work.
The gods are angry.
Oh, we weren't supposed to do fire in the temple.
And a giant scorpion comes out from underneath him.
Okay, that's great. Wow. It's helpful, right? Because I spoke like about Osiris, and I've got the metal, so it's going to help us out. Here we go, guys.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Yay, scorpion friend!
Woo!
Yeah, maybe not so much.
Maybe, that's not a no. Nope.
I don't even see any of this going on.
He's a neutral observer.
Right. Yep. The watcher.
Sure.
Yeah, so there's a lot of stuff going on in that room.
I'm going to advance backwards some more.
I'm going to go after the one who's screaming.
Me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Head back towards the room, I guess. I'm gonna regret this. My massive pile of 7 hit points. And well, you have now made short friends that seem keen on stabbing you. So,
you want one of these potions
even
before
more.
You go?
You're too far away.
Well, I don't even know who had all of them.
I don't know. But I guess I'll move 30 feet back in your direction and cast blight on one of those kobolds.
Okay.
Shield or no shield?
The no shield.
The no shield.
The no shield.
That works.
Yeah. So I need a con save.
Yeah. Con save?
Yes.
Yeah. That's a whopping 11.
Okay. Looks like it's going to be 27 necrotic.
Oh, wow.
As their form just shrivels and crumbles to dust
yes,
in front of you.
Yes, actually it does. It crumbles and shrivels.
Yeah,
and
yeah, yeah, I was right.
Since I don't see you, so I think I did that. I'm like, ah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's all you, buddy.
Greta.
All right.
Build him to death.
I'm going to quicken greater invisibility on myself.
Oh.
And then I'm going to serpentine advance up the hallway just far enough to cast a firebolt at the dragon. Do I get advantage as I'm invisible?
Yes.
Yes. All right. Well, that's 19.
19. We'll hit.
All right. That is 17 whole points. No, I am going to add my plus 3 to that. My
okay.
So 20 whole points of fire.
Hey.
Yes. We've got this.
We've got this.
You can't see me.
Yeah. Yes.
About. And as my last action, since I just ran and took it to the side.
Just so it's harder for it to guess where that all came from, because
the hallway's only 10 foot wide, so I can only.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. It's turn.
No.
Ooh, we recharge.
Oh, no.
It doesn't know where I'm at.
Well, damn.
Yeah.
Hi.
Oh, hey. No, you don't have to apologize for killing them. It's okay.
No.
Yeah, I do like us better. Know, we're some years
know,
friendship.
It does know where the spells have been coming from. What?
Well, I mean, first it takes. Is it dead from my starting its turn in my spirit
How
guardians?
How much damage?
Let's find out. I'm sure it's plenty. It's plenty. It's
sure it's exactly what he has.
Kill a dragon.
126. It was 3d8. I may have added. Okay, I think that was like 12.
You read well,
no,
sequentially.
No, it was 14.
14.
Now we don't know what the
14
truth
necrotic.
Is.
There is no truth.
You're not
is
quite
it dead?
At half.
Does it fall?
You're
I move.
Not half, you're not quite at half.
Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Give me a dexterity saving throw. And it's just on you.
Yeah, just like a shower of lightning.
Just a grudge
yeah,
breath.
Because nobody else is actually that close
yeah,
to you
no,
anymore.
And
just you specifically.
That's totally cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm limited to one action.
Oh.
How many rerolls do we get on this? Do we have one action? Okay.
For you? None.
Yeah. So how much damage do I take?
55. Okay. Yeah, 55.
Grom goes down to one knee, and then he stands again with one hit.
Oh my God!
Oh God!
Because
we are orc.
We are orc.
Oh, half.
He's
half.
Toast.
Half. Half. Mm-hmm.
So Grimble, you're up.
Grimble has just observed the dragon rear back, despite his most potent magic, rear back its head, and then breathe a thunderstorm into his face. That is.
Well, one action is one action.
That's true. But it's troubling to see what, you know, what dragons are capable of.
Mm.
So, Grimble.
It is still stuck there, and it will take damage again, because it will start its next turn.
We've got it where we want it.
You should keep it where it can only do one action.
Is that a concentration?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you should.
Yeah.
Oh, dear me.
There
yeah,
help, there help.
DC for that.
It's a bit. It's a bit. I have,
really high, though.
This is not bad, 19 plus, what do I add? I add my constitution. Yeah, so it's a 21, and what did I need?
How much damage did you take?
55.
Can he?
Isn't that half the damage you took?
Yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's half the damage.
So I
10 or half the
27
damage?
Yeah.
I thank my spirits for their loyal service.
Yes.
Okay.
Grandma proud.
Okay, Grimble.
And I shed a little tear.
They did their best.
Mm-hmm.
That's blood, actually. It wasn't a tear.
All right. So Grimble will advance 30 feet up his movement. So pretty close to the opening now. And I will look over at Grom, who just heroically took a lightning bolt to the face. And as a bonus action, you, sir, will regain 15 hit points, which is about the best I could possibly do.
It's great. It's plenty.
No, it's not. but it's what I could do.
Yeah.
And then, Grimble is going to. No, I already used my bonus action. To heal this guy, is going to wing, he's going to concentrate and send a spectral hand out to caress the front of the dragon, hitting an armor class of 22.
Oh yeah, that hits.
Nice.
Oh yeah.
For 12 points of necrotic damage.
Okay. I try to talk to the dragon. I can speak to the dragon.
I'm sure that will go over like a fart in church.
Okay, fine.
It is not an undead target, so that doesn't matter. And Grimble has done all the things that he
can. Okay, five eyes.
Oh, so I'm in front of a
kobold
with a
shield and the spear.
Why don't we shock and grasp him?
Okay.
Oh, that's nice.
Sounds like a good thing to do.
Yeah, you can pretty well.
Unless you're on natural one, then it's not so good. So I'm. He won't hold
nimble
still.
Nimble little kobold.
Yeah.
Still, you little bugger.
And he will no longer have pack tactics.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah. Your friend's gone now.
Yeah.
What do you think
his
about that?
His friend's gone.
Natural
20. So sneezes.
We'll just make his two attacks without advantage. And miss.
What?
Yes. I rolled a 2 and a 4. Yeah. That's a miss.
I like that.
Grom, you're up.
Oh, it's my turn again?
Your turn again.
Do it.
That guy? Tank it?
Tank it. Yep.
Grom, reach into bag.
Mm-hmm.
Pull out grandma's lucky token.
Okay.
It lucky halfling foot. And I put around neck, which is casting the spell. And then and then I look up and say, is that all you got?
You gonna tell everyone else
you
cast
it?
No. Okay.
Oh, okay. All right. No,
and
cool.
He's put some luck around himself.
And that's all I can do.
Okay. Okay, so over here we have you and the dragon,
mm-hmm.
and we have you and him and the
kobold,
yeah.
and you're near them.
Sure.
Okay, and you're at the front of the hallway?
Yeah, I'm like, I would be right like 10 feet from the entrance of the hallway.
Okay.
And I'm like 20 feet behind him.
You're 20 feet behind him. So, target-wise...
Nope, absolutely not.
I mean, I did just goad him on.
I'm still invisible.
No. The giant scorpion.
What?
Oh, I was hoping that just
out
slapped.
From underneath the.
I forgot about him.
I
hey,
did not
buddy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. No. It's. You're using both D's. Dungeon
I
and
would,
undead.
I would not normally.
Yeah. No.
You know,
I'm here for you.
But. You know, your buddies kind of left you out to dry,
mm-hmm.
sort of. Mm-hmm. So the orange are the claws, and the blue will be the sting.
It dead, no poison.
Okay. No, it's a live giant scorpion. But I think I missed with all of them because I don't think an 11 hit you.
No.
And I'm pretty darn sure that a, yeah, no.
All right.
Oh,
11 was the best one.
Fight valiantly in my last moments.
He didn't attack with, like, you know, conviction.
Yeah.
However,
around you
is a field of gillyflowers.
Sand seems to be swandering around.
Oh, I don't like that at all.
And,
Oh, it's exfoliating.
Yes. It's good for my psoriasis.
It's a good scour.
Give me a constitution saving throw, you're blinded for a minute.
Oh, God.
That seems not great for you.
Oh, my. Blinded for a minute.
From a distance.
As well as getting sand in your loot, so that's going to be...
Oh, not sand. I got sand in my loot. so, hold on. You said that was a con save,
yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Roll. Please roll.
A 16?
Enough.
Hooray!
Now I you don't
grit.
You're not blinded for a minute, but you do still have sand in your loot.
Oh, Dirth. No.
Euphemism.
Oh, God.
Do the thing.
I'm running low on options. I will attempt to use frostbite on the kobold
mm-hmm.
that is over on Strom, so I do need a constitution
save. Why is nobody attacking the obvious target?
He's trying to help his friend.
It's attention.
Sorry. 20 on the die.
Yeah, it was worth a shot.
Yep.
But that's about the best I have. I will then move up next to Strom.
Okay. Greta.
All right.
I think we have packed.
You saw the big, because it had to walk in front of the Yep. Yep. Entrance to the hallway. So you do know about the scorpion. Sure do. So gonna advance to where Grimble is, but not any further. It seems unnecessary. I'm going to quicken. Scorching Ray. And upcast that at the dragon.
Okay.
Let's see, so whoops, I need to actually roll the attack. Well, my highest is 15.
You could lie. Say a higher number.
Cool. All right. Then for my last, I'm going to shoot that firebolt. Again. That's 16.
16 will miss also.
Well,
it is a dragon. It has
and then I'm armor. Going to reiterate that I'm still invisible.
Did I mention?
Just in case anybody forgot. All right.
Okay. Well, let's see if it.
Let's hope it doesn't.
It does. It did not read.
That's hooray!
Instead, okay. It will just bite your face off.
Yeah. Well, there is that part.
There is that part.
If your face is visible.
True.
But, you know. What? Okay, so you're still in the hallway.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm with him.
You're with him.
He's right in front of it.
He's right in front
right
of
there.
It.
I'm okay. Right there.
It's starting its turn and you... Oh, it's gone. Never mind.
It's just my normal smell.
Right, exactly.
Oh, no. All right. Oh, no. Oh, no.
I see some big numbers over there.
Those look like big numbers.
I don't feel good.
So the bite is a 20.
Okay, I will allow that.
And the one claw is a 28.
I'm going to allow that one
and
as
the other
well.
One's an 18.
That's exactly what we need. So. Okay.
That he won't allow, but yeah. He'll still take the damage.
So the bite did 16 damage.
Okay.
And the two claws did a total of 24.
So when the claws hit, my death ward kicks in. My lucky halfling's foot drops from my neck, and I have one hit.
Okay. Grimble.
Grimble is seriously impressed with the amount of punishment that this orc can endure. He's like, wow! Yeah. Man, I under... He's like, he's kind of dumb, but... He is a tough one.
But that healing is why. If you hadn't done that healing, it would have been totally terrible.
Yeah.
So that was good.
Oh gosh. What is Grimble gonna do? He is... How hurt does the, like, on a scale of 1 to 10, how hurt does the dragon look?
On the scale of 1 to 10, he's close to half.
Oh, Jesus.
Again, why has nobody been attacking the obvious target?
I have been attacking the obvious target, but there's other targets that can do bad things, too. Grimble's going to, he's going to sigh. And he is going to, if possible, 30 feet of movement, run up to, why can't I remember your
Grom.
Name? Grom. And he is going to whisper something into your ear, which I will give you in a moment.
Sweet nothings.
And touch your, yes, and touch your back. You are now invisible.
What? Powerful
and,
magics.
And, he will whisper. Yeah.
Okay.
And then Grimble is out of movement. He has cast a spell. And as a golly gee whiz. How hurt does this guy?
Quite.
Strong. Or Dorf?
I'm okay.
You're okay?
I'm okay.
That guy?
I'm extra crispy.
You're extra crispy. That is the worst kind of crispy.
7 hit points.
That is bad. Yeah, that's no fun at all.
I'm not much better. Just for
yeah, well, you know.
I know, but
I can only do so much.
I'm invisible too, so it's okay.
All right, cool. So we're gonna cast that spell, and then we are going to.
All right,
use our last third level spell slot, and we are going to heal Dearth for 9 points of healing.
Thank you.
You get it's a very inspiring little ditty to lift your flagging spirits. Mm. And then Grimble's going to wait for the dragon to tear him apart from the butthole. Mm.
All right.
Five eyes.
Is there any way I could hit the dragon with a fireball?
Sure.
And miss everyone else?
Yeah.
Let's do that thing, and I will upcast it at fourth level.
It's a large flying critter, so it's at least 5 foot off the ground.
And I'm hoping it will fall on them.
Dude!
Did I say that out loud?
You did!
I'm sorry.
Said it with words, and they hurt.
Hurtful words.
If you were being reckless with it, you could hit people, but...
No. Be careful.
Let's see. 96. I see a few sixes there. 30 points of fire damage.
All right.
DC 16. Dexterity saving throw.
Okay, so I have plus 4 my dex saves.
Oh, I have so few.
And I got a kitty cat, so that's 20. So 24, right. So I make save.
15 points of fire damage.
15 points of fire damage.
And I look at the shield-bearing kobold next to him, I'm like, you're next.
That's a good thing. All right, it is now more than half. I'm assuming that's a little... Okay. He looks a little scared.
No. All right.
He's probably going to be at disadvantage in this attack at you.
Okay.
No.
Which you really didn't need to have him at disadvantage because the dice are not necessarily... Okay, so that's the best was 11 with disadvantage and a failure at disadvantage. So the two attacks miss you. He's obviously shaking in his boots. Grum, you're invisible.
Move around very quietly.
Oh, God, I think it has blind sight. God bless him.
It doesn't matter. It's still advantage. We're just gonna go for it. I'm gonna count on both of us dying soon, so I'm just gonna try to deal the maximum amount of damage with what you've given me.
All right.
So I conjure. I silently, because don't want to give away position.
Yeah.
Grom, think to Osiris. Now time, man with symbol of funny hat. Give me your blessing. And that's gonna be a 18 to hit it.
Hits.
Yes. All right, so that's going to be a lot of D10s.
Good. How many D10s?
All the D10s. It's the maximum D10s. So let's see, that's 3, 4, 5, 6 D10s.
Oh, my 14, God.
14 and 11 is 21. 21 and 13 is 34. How many others?
21. Yeah.
Okay. That was four.
Four?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And another 10. So that's, math. Why is math that way?
44, I thought.
44?
I thought he was 34, then 10,
yeah, 44.
We can map, kids!
44,
D&D
and
helps you understand
math. Then I inject another 21 necrotic.
How?
Because I'm
it's a
death.
Class.
It's,
oh, okay.
It's what we do.
It's what you death. Okay.
You bought me this time. I go out like
and
this.
It
falls. Yeah!
Go team death.
I quickly stand upon it. Plant a flag.
Look, don't get cocky, man. There's still a big ass scorpion over there. Let's one thing at a time. All right. You're still almost dead.
I'd like to thank the designer of Inflict Wounds and the Death Cleric.
I'm like, God, I didn't know you could do that.
It's pretty scary.
Yeah, no.
All right, so we're there are still things here, though.
Yeah.
There's
focused.
A kobold and a scorpion, right?
Right.
Well, yes. I mean, after killing a dragon, what could possibly...
I have one hit point.
I know.
So scorpion will attack you.
Of course it will.
I am not happy with that turn of events.
Tail will totally miss. However... The claws were 22 and a 23.
Well, that puts it just out of the range of my shield, so I'm going to say I have incurred some damage.
Okay, so you take
12 damage in your grappled.
Oh, that's not good.
That's less than ideal. I can't fireball it now. It's got
you. That doesn't happen anymore. Dearth!
You plan on making an attack? Like an attack roll?
Sure.
I will use the aid action.
Okay. Greta.
Well, I'm just gonna fireball, yeah. I guess not. I'm gonna quicken a scorching ray.
Mm-hmm.
Over at the scorpion.
Mm-hmm.
First one's a 21.
Okay.
For 10 points.
Okay,
that was it. Second ray is 15.
15 is exactly what you need.
For 7 more.
Okay.
And last one is 21 for 11, and I'm going to choose to add my additional 3 this time because I keep forgetting. So 14.
Okay.
Then I'm going to, with my normal action, since I clicked on that, cast my firebolt.
Yeah. Okay.
So that's a 10. Oh no, I'm hiding. I'm invisible. 25.
25 to hit,
hits. Or 11 more damage.
All right.
Yeah.
Wow.
Good
it's
job.
Excellent.
Looking very bad.
Plus 3.
Or very good, depending on your perspective.
Right.
It's good to see both sides.
Yeah. And then I'm going to step forward out of the hallway so I can see it. I'm going to step back into the hallway.
Okay. Grimble.
Grimble is Grimble grappled.
Yes.
Oh, I forgot about that.
That's fine. That's fine. Grimble has this fancy kind of jagged-looking dagger with an opal in the palm. He's going to pull that dagger out. And he, oh, my God, it hurts because he's, you know, he's in a scorpion's claw. And he's going to take that dagger, bam, and try to jam it into the claw and, like, tear out a piece of scorpion meat.
Okay.
Let's see how this
what that is like.
Sand lobster.
Armor class 25.
Oh, yeah, that'll hit.
Fantastic. And as he does this, Grimble closes his eyes and concentrate and expend a use of his bardic inspiration and do an extra 2d6 psychic damage to it. As
wow.
He fills its silly scorpion. So 4 points of dagger damage. And then. Boop, boop.
But wait, there's more.
But wait, there's more.
He also gets
6 more points of psychic damage. So a total of 10 points of damage.
Yeah.
And then look hopefully to see if it dies.
Mm-hmm. Your hopes have been rewarded.
Scorpion dun, Slayer.
Dun, 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 dun. I don't know if we can do that on stream.
Do we? I think it was just off key enough. We're good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have no idea what you're trying to say.
So
anyway.
You're safe.
Yeah, I'm not gonna. Say
bye, guys.
Right,
I will try to shocking grasp.
Okay.
With advantage,
yes.
Thanks to my friend here.
Yep.
My little friend. So that is.
I distract it with taunts
22
and ugly dance.
Oh yeah.
Or a natural 1. So thank you.
Yep.
Thank you very much. 2d8 plus I will channel 4 points more. So 3 and 5 is 8 plus 4 is 12 points of lightning damage, and it cannot take reactions. Except
and it has
dead.
Resistance to lightning.
Still? Still?
Because it's a blue.
Yeah.
That's
it's
fine.
A blue cobalt.
That's okay. Yeah.
It's better than the 0 we could have dealt otherwise.
Those that's are so correct. Pretty, though. I mean,
yeah.
Really.
They are. Yeah. So really. Pretty.
Just lost in the dreamy flies. Scales.
Shiny. Like, that's so nice. If you got to die to a cobalt, you want it to be the blue one.
Yeah, really. That's true.
You hurt me.
Yes.
So that's a crit.
Oh, God.
Okay, that'll
and,
learn you.
We earned this.
Yeah.
And a 19.
I will put up a shield.
Okay, so that. Just the crit?
Just the crit. Just
the
82 points of damage from the crit. No problem.
No. You're going to roll dice for it.
Oh, okay.
You see the
as a reaction, card. I go, ooh.
Yeah.
It's a death cleric. Oh, no.
It's got some hurt.
Oh, can we do that? I'll just remind you to go, ah.
Yeah, you can do that. I mean, it uses your reaction, though. But
yeah. Well, I don't have anything else to use.
Yeah, it's the same.
Okay.
Not true.
So that's 9, 10 damage piercing.
Okay. I can take that.
Are you alive?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I used absorb elements.
So
oh, that's
the
right.
First attack, so I took almost nothing.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
That's a thing you can
all right. So we have a blue kobold up.
Yeah.
All right. I will... Yeah, okay. I will toll the dead on it. Because nobody's down, right?
Nope. Mm.
That's it.
All right.
No. Like almost. You're the closest.
Make despite a wisdom saving throw.
Okay. He's still fighting, so that's a, like an automatic fail, isn't it? He failed that wisdom saving throw.
That will be 11 necrotic damage.
Dead yet? Is dead yet?
How about
dead
now?
No. He didn't get a lot of damage from Five Eyes earlier, so.
Okay.
Darth?
Is somebody really close to death?
You said yourself?
I mean, me.
No.
Okay.
No.
I'll healing word myself.
7 points? Oh, you got healed.
I get healed a little bit, yeah. We are running low on options. I'm going to use my action to recharge one of my spell slots out of my Rod of the Pact Keeper.
Okay.
And hope that I survive to use it.
Okay.
I hope you do, too.
Greta. I don't have any more sorcery points, so I can't do anything like that. So I'm going to use my last third level spell slot to scorching ray the little kobold because it's not lightning. All right. So first ray, 25.
Yes.
For 8 points.
Okay.
Second ray is 23.
Yeah.
For 7 points.
Okay.
Good.
And the last one is 9, even with the damage.
Oh.
Boo. Yeah. 9, yeah, no.
All right. I'm down to, like, fiddling stuff left.
Mm-hmm.
Grimble?
Grimble is very impressed by this kobold's tenacity.
Right.
And as a show of...
appreciation.
How little he thinks of that. he is going to...
He's being attacked by goblins and half-orcs. He doesn't think he's got a choice here.
No, he really doesn't. It's going to take the blade of his dagger and pick out a funny little ditty on the lute. And I would really enjoy it if the kobold would attempt a wisdom saving throw DC 15.
Okay. And that's a crock. Okay, so that's a 3 on the die, so...
Oh, right. So he is enchanted and finds this little ditty hilarious, falls prone, and gets to make a wisdom saving throw at the end of his next turn.
Okay.
And every subsequent turn.
Five Eyes, your opponent is now prone.
Yep.
Come
yeah. I am going to then back away from him.
Okay.
And let's do a shatter on him.
My God.
Just, sure. just for effect.
Just for effect.
So DC 16 con save.
Okay. 20.
That's a cat.
You got a cat. Okay. 20 points of 10.
So 10.
Yep.
20 points of time.
Yeah, time flavored damage.
Got it. He gets to make a saving throw on the Tasha's Hideous Laughter. Because
okay.
He took damage.
Okay.
Unless he's dead.
No, he's not dead. He has 2 hit points.
Oh, damn.
And he made it, I believe.
Yeah. That's 15 is the DC.
16 on the die.
You have really soured the how the joke was landing with him in his head. But he is still prone. So
he is still prone. And you're moved back from him, so he's going to use his movement to get up, because nobody's adjacent,
right?
Nope.
Right?
Nope.
Looking around, you're not close enough for him to get to.
I might be. I mean, I'm visible.
Yeah, you're visible, and...
I have to be within 30 feet of him because I cast Tasha's.
Right.
Yeah. You know.
So he's going to go kamikaze.
Oh.
And basically drop the shield, put 2 hands on the spear, and run at you.
Well, that's not very nice.
He just took a level in barbarian mid-combat.
Mid-combat. He got so mad.
Jeez, man.
And
no
failed
an
entirely to hit you.
No.
Okay. So Grimble does like an elegant sidestep.
Yeah. And he continues moving right past you.
Stick your foot out.
Oh, do I get an opportunity attack?
Sure.
Yeah, kill him.
On dagger.
Hit him with the dagger.
Hit him with the loot. Hit him with the loot.
No, that's not.
He has the dagger in hand. We have established this.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah?
Although, I do like the idea of a loot bashing. let's see here.
Well deserved loot bash.
Nah, it's only AC.
So was he really trying to hit him or just trying to escape?
He doesn't have a shield anymore.
He doesn't have a shield anymore, but I still. It's just AC 12. Pretty poopy.
Yeah.
Nope.
AC
13
without.
Yeah.
Oh,
so
okay.
Close. So close.
How dare he?
All right.
All right. Grom say, you should work for us. You need a new employer.
What? So out of the invisible area. No,
no, I'm not invisible. I'm visible.
That's right.
Covered in blood.
All right, give me, you trying to intimidate or persuade?
I mean, that sounded like a persuasion.
That did. It did.
That's a 5.
Intimisuasion.
If I work for you, do I live?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
look at us, all alive. Nothing stop us. We great place to work.
Dragon.
You know?
There's no benefits, though.
One of our goblins is part dragon. It's like cousin moved or something. I don't even know how it works.
Okay.
Hooray!
I'm sorry, he has 2 hit points left. Right. All his compadres are
He's
dead.
Motivated.
And you offered him a way out.
Welcome to the club.
Highly motivated.
Welcome to the club.
He sold to the kobold with 2 hit points.
Right. Motivated employees.
And then we loot the temple.
Yeah, well, you can.
Show us where all the good stuff is.
It's right here. Literally everything is right
there
here.
There might be stuff hidden somewhere.
That's true.
No, there's just stupid food.
Just stupid
food. Just stupid food.
Yes.
Where do you keep the smart food?
They haven't.
I haven't found any.
They haven't invented that yet.
Right.
Stupid food. No, this is all the gold and stuff, and we actually had to go out and rob some people to keep the dragon happy, because all the hallways have strange storage that keeps food good for a long time.
Oh, that's
as long
handy.
As you like. Things like wine and stuff.
I do. Gotta love wine.
No, I'm good with that.
We know people who reward us for this.
Yes.
Don't worry.
All right.
Also, you come back with us.
I think it's time to get drunk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So our intrepid heroes have managed to
not burn down the temple.
Not burn down the temple.
Nope.
They did not make the mess.
No.
It's true.
So since there was some other things probably in there that did not belong to the temple in the first place. A tidy sum in gems and wondrous stuff was
well spent,
well earned by the group. And you've now made a reputation for half-orc and goblin superiority.
Yes.
Yes!
In temple cleaning.
Yep.
And
We have a reputation as
temple cleaners.
As temple cleaners.
As housekeepers?
It's bad typecasting.
No, it's like it's good. It's good. It's exciting. Versus
job security, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
So
it pays surprisingly well.
Thank you for watching on and participating in this extra live stream, and please help the kids.
Right. Yay! Help
Thanks,
the
everybody.
Kids.
Thank you. Extra life.